Welcome to the Climate and Water Outlook for Winter 2015. As you may have heard, El Niño is back. This means a greater chance of below average rainfall over eastern Australia in the second half of the year. However, the Indian Ocean is still warm, meaning more rain may fall in the west before El Niño takes over. But first, let's check on current water availability. Parts of southern Australia had good autumn rains, with the Murray-Darling Basin receiving 26% more rain than average in April. Two east coast lows brought flooding to parts of northern New South Wales and southern Queensland in mid-April and early May. Unfortunately, the rains have done little to relieve the long-term severe rainfall deficiencies in central Queensland, northern New South Wales and western Victoria. The rains have improved moisture in the top layers of the soil in some areas, helping some with their winter crop planting. But deep soil moisture is still well below average in many key agricultural areas. Water storage levels are mixed leading into winter. Storages along the southeast coast are fuller than this time last year, but some in the Murray-Darling Basin have fallen significantly. The Menindee Lakes, which supply Broken Hill and districts, are practically empty. Let's see what may drive Australia's climate in the coming months. Now that El Niño has been declared, its impacts become more likely as we progress through winter. Unlike last year, all of the models we survey predict El Niño conditions at least until mid-spring. So what could this mean? El Niño is often associated with below average winter and spring rainfall over eastern Australia and above average daytime temperatures over southern Australia. Less rainfall and more cloud-free nights mean the frost season is also likely to be longer than average. With reduced rainfall and more heat drying out the soils, lower stream flows are often experienced in the late winter and spring of El Niño years. But El Niño isn't the only influence on our climate. The Indian Ocean is still warmer than normal, which could provide moisture for winter rainfall. But we're keeping an eye on the waters south of Sumatra. About half the models are hinting this area may cool, which could actually intensify El Niño impacts. So what is the rainfall outlook for June to August? The warm Indian Ocean is slowly being overtaken by the El Niño in the Pacific as the dominating driver of our three-month outlook. Wetter than average conditions are more likely for parts of Western Australia, but in the eastern states, odds now lean towards average to below average rainfall. Our rainfall outlook has moderate accuracy at this time of year. So what can we expect from stream flows? Our forecast to the end of July indicates lower than usual flows at 34 of 82 locations. Median flows are forecast at 18 locations. High flows are more likely at 30 locations, mostly near the southeastern coast due to rain from the east coast lows in April and May. Accuracy for our streamflow forecast is moderate at this time of year. Now turning to temperature. The odds favour warmer than average days and clearer skies in the east, and cooler than usual days across inland Western Australia as cloud and moisture blow in from the west. Nights are likely to be warmer than average in most areas. So in summary, rainfall outlooks favour wetter conditions in the west, but with El Niño in play, winter looks drier than average for eastern Australia. Higher than average stream flows are expected along the southeast coast. Inland, deep soils are still dry and low flows are likely to continue. For more details, head to our website at bom.gov.au/climate/ahead. You can also follow us on Facebook and Twitter. Our next video will be released on Thursday, the 25th of June. For the Bureau of Meteorology, I'm Paul Feikema.